There has never been a Native American woman elected to Congress until now. Two representatives will become the first Native American women elected to Congress. One of those women has ties to our area. News 8's Scott Behrens has the story.
Charisse Davids is a member of the Ho-Chunk Nation, and she's a woman of many firsts. She's the first person in her family to go to college, the first LGBTQ congressional candidate to win in Kansas, and the first Native American woman to ever be elected to Congress. But it almost never happened.
It just literally did not cross my mind that I would ever run for Congress, much less run for any elected office.
Charisse Davids was raised by a single mother who served in the military.
My mom was born in Black River Falls. My mom joined the Army, so I also grew up an Army brat. And that's how we ended up in Kansas, because she retired after 20 years of serving in the Army at Fort Leavenworth in Kansas.
Like her mom, Davids never shied away from a fight, even competing professionally in MMA.
Certainly, having trained for mixed martial arts gave me a wealth of experience that played a big role in how I both prepared and dealt with the campaign cycle. Partly because all the work that you do determines whether or not you win or lose long before the actual night of the election.
Now that she's made history by winning a seat in Congress, Davids hopes other Native American women will follow her lead.
Changing the norm and resetting expectations is the most beautiful thing that came out of this election cycle, I think.
She says having a Congress that better resembles the U.S. population will benefit everyone.
I think the importance of having a diversity of thought, of ideology, of backgrounds and lived experience is that people will learn from each other.
Wisconsin Lieutenant Governor-elect Mandela Barnes agrees.
Whether it's diversity of experience, whether it's race, whether it's gender, whatever the case may be, there are more candidates who can speak to a larger section of the population.
David's family members say she's proving anything can be possible.
There are no obstacles except the ones that you put in front of yourself. And I really think that with her running and winning, it's a good positive role model to show that you can do whatever you want to do. You just have to make the effort to do it.
Davids can't wait to see what happens next.
I'm really excited for the future of our country.
Davids says she wants to make it easier to register to vote. She also wants to ensure people have access to affordable, quality health care.
All right, thank you, Scott. In addition to Davids and Barnes, several state and local politicians were in attendance, including Ron Kind.